Okay, in the step three, after the reaction of the protonic species with the diol, it tend to produce triol. Okay, triol mean that means that contain tiga OH group. And in the step three, the loss of water, when the reversible reaction involve the rate constant 5, they can produce C double bond O. And OH kat sini semua hilang. Okay, kat sini OH hilang. And regeneration of the catalyst to produce CO plus HE, H plus A. H plus A is the protonic acid. In the catalyzed reaction, kita panggil sebagai external system. External system means that kita letak catalyst dalam reaction tu. If polymerization reaction is first order with respect to the each functional group of A1, so means that it is a catalyzed reaction. First order tu maknanya dia catalyzed. Kalau second order, it is uncatalyzed. And the rate of a step polymerization is conveniently expressed in terms of the concentration of the reacting functional group. Maknanya, concentration of the monomer tu, kita measure kinetik dia dalam setiap polymerization process tu. And the rate of polymerization, which is Rp, can then be expressed as the rate of disappearance of the carboxylic acid, denominated by R equal to negative T COOH over different shade of time. And for the usual polyesterification, the polymerization rate is synonym with the rate of formation of species 2. The reaction is run under condition that derive equation 1 to 3 and 1 to 4 to the right, and K1, K2 and K5 are large compared to K3. Now we look at the kinetic step. So yang ni awak tak payah hafal. Cuba awak kena faham je. So COOH is the concentration of carboxylic acid ni. Kita nak buat polyester kan. Dia involve monomer carboxylic acid. Dia ada monomer OH, which is hydroxy group. And also COOH, concentration of protonated carboxyl group. So, first step, kita differentiate kan concentration COOH, monomer COOH dulu. Equal to K3 adalah rate constant. Rate constant COOH and OH. Okay. And the concentration terms are in units of mole of the particular functional group per liter of solution. So, dalam mole ni yang kena awak kena tahu measure dia punya stoichiometric balance. Equation 1 to 5 is inconvenient in that the concentration of protonated carboxyl group is not easily determined experimentally. And one can obtain a more convenient expression for rate of polymerization by substituting for COH2 from the equilibrium expression for the protonation reaction. So K1 over K2 is COOH over COOH times with HA. When we combine the equation 1 to 5 and 1 to 6, we will produce K3KCOOHOHCA. Ini dia tukar kedudukan je. Bila dia combine, dia replace. Dia replace equation. Dia insert je lah. And if the polymerization reaction is first order with respect to each functional group reactant A and B. A and B ni COOH dengan OH tadi lah. So, kita boleh expresskan the rate of polymerization is negative dA over dT equal to K A and B. So, we assume concentration of monomer A is equal to the concentration of monomer B. And K is a rate constant of concentration of monomer A square. Square ke? Bukan square kan? K A to the power of 2. And then we integrate this equation Ha, inilah fungsi awak belajar calculus ataupun calculus ke? Calculus ke eh? Tak ingat saya. Kita integratekan reaction tu. Reaction 3. Okay, yang ni reaction 1 to 9 tu kita integratekan dia. Kita akan dapat 1 over A minus 1 over A naught. So at any time, T in the polymerization process TP is equal to the ratio of monomer molecule present initially to the total number at that time. So as we all know, DP is equal to A naught over A ataupun N naught over N. Kan? Sebab kita refer kepada monomer A, so kita letak A lah. Combine the above expression with the characteristic equation and solving for A. Macam mana? So A equal to A naught 1 minus B. Kita akan masukkan dalam kita masukkan equation yang ini A ni kita masukkan dalam mana tadi masukkan dalam equation ni. Okey, so kita akan dapat macam ni, and then since DP is equal to 1 over 1 minus B, so gantikanlah dia. Kita akan dapat lama dia punya time equal to degree of polymerization minus 1 concentration A K. Ini adalah final equation. Soalan dia, soalan final biasa dia akan tanya, dia akan bagi macam ni. Dia akan bagi equation ni. Okay, please derive the equation given by the dia pun bagilah equation DP equal to A naught KT plus 1. So kalau equation ini, dia represent the catalyzed condensation. Okay, kinetic polycondensation type 1. So if K is known, the time T needed to reach any number average MW for a given concentration of monomer can be calculated. So saya ada nota yang masa saya zaman saya belajar degree dulu. Kalau korang tak faham macam mana dia boleh jadi macam tu, korang boleh refer lah nota ni. Sebab ni tak muat. Boleh copy dulu kot, letak dekat word lain ke kan. So, boleh nampak lah macam mana saya integratekan dia, macam mana saya differentiatekan dia. Okay, nanti I will give you this slide and you can refer to my handwriting. Kalau faham ke tak, kalau tak faham, tanya ya. The uncatalyzed reaction is slow and a high degree of polymerization is not readily attained. So in the presence of the catalyst, there is an acceleration of the rate and the kinetic for catalyzed system express the rate of reaction dependent on the external catalyst. Maksud dia kat sini, bila kita letak catalyst, which is dalam external system tadi, dalam type 1 tadi, dia akan increasekan the rate of the polymerization. Okay, now kita tengok self-catalyzed polymerization. Bagi contoh yang sama, which is polyesterification without the acidic catalyst. Yang tadi kita letak acid catalyst kan. Yang ni tak letak catalyst. Because in the absence of an externally added strong acid and diacid monomer, because of the monomer sendiri, monomer itself act as its own catalyst for the esterification system in self-catalyzed polymerization. Okay, for a self-catalyzed, the number average degree of polymerization grows proportionally with time. And for this case, HA is replaced by COOH. And equation 1 to 7 can be written in the usual form. Dia akan ada kuasa 2, okay? Kuasa 2, OH. Tak samalah yang macam tadi. Sebab dia beza dia, dia ada kuasa 2. Sebab dia react dengan diri dia sendiri. So, K and K3 have been combined into the experimentally determined rate constant K. Lies. Dia akan tanya, kalau soalan tanya, derive the equation DP to the power of 2, 2KT A naught to the power of 2 plus 1. Derive the equation involve this equation, kan? So, awak kena derive yang uncatalyzed lah. And dia punya explanation dia, if no acid catalyst is added, the reaction will still be proceed because acid can act as its own catalyst. and the kinetic force self-catalyzed system shows that the rate of reaction dependent on the strong acid which acts as a catalyst, and degree of polymerization grows proportionally with time. So dekat sini pun saya bagi juga saya punya handwriting, tak tahulah clear ke tak. Kalau tak clear nanti beritahu, saya akan snap gambar letak dekat WhatsApp group ya. This one is the graph for the polymerization kinetic involved catalyzed and uncatalyzed. You can see the catalyzed system produce a straight line first order reaction, and for uncatalyzed system it is not a straight line and it is a second order uncatalyzed. And if the purity of the monomer is decreased, okay, slow ataupun sikit dia punya purity of monomer tu sangat kurang, kita akan produce low P, low S, low conversion. So kalau boleh purity of the monomer must be pure lah, 100% pure lah. Okay, now we proceed with the stoichiometry imbalance. In some important application, it is necessary to limit the molecular weight. For example, we have epoxy resin and unsaturated polyester and also polyamide. Maksud dia kat sini, bila kita produce polymer tu, kita nak kena capai dia punya masa di mana polymer tu berhenti produce. Dalam contoh the making of the epoxy resin, there is a stage which are required polymer to be converted into the network by appropriate reaction of terminal epoxide group. So we need some number of mole that is exact. And in the preparation of unsaturated polyester are processed to the moderately low molecular weight before being crosslinked. Maksud dia, in the early stage of the polyester, dia produce dekat molecular weight yang slow je, supaya kalau kita terus buat dia jadi tinggi, kan, dia akan jadi gelation, kan. So, kena ada number of the stoichiometric balance yang tepat. And the last one is the preparation of polyamide. For fiber application, molecular weight must often be limited because too high a viscosity is damaging to extrusion of filament through the fine holes of a spinneret. Macam mana kita nak produce high molecular weight polymer? Yang tadi cerita pasal ada setengah-setengah polymer yang tak memerlukan high molecular weight, kan? Macam mana kita nak control dia? Any synthesis of high molecular weight polymer. In order to achieve synthesis of high molecular weight step-proof polymer, there are a few things can be considered, which are we must remove byproduct. Okay, kalau kita nak produce high conversion, which is 100%, kita kena remove byproduct to drive the reaction to high conversion. And formation of cyclic compound can make the reaction become slow. Cyclic compound tu adalah salah satu daripada type of byproduct. That's why for the polymerization process, we must control the elimination of water by use a nitrogen gas during the synthesis. Or we can also distillation under high vacuum or by the azeotrophic distillation. The second one, we must use the exact stoichiometric balance, because only the exact amount of mole, number of mole of that monomer, we can control the monomer feed composition. And also, we need to use the equivalent number of functional group which lead to the favorable equilibrium, and consider also the purity of that monomer. And because if there is presence of some contamination, it will react with that contamination and will decrease the conversion percentage. Lagi kita kena achieve high monomer conversion, which is 98%. And the last one, we must have the equivalent monomer feed composition, which is ratio of feed is equivalent. Samalah